you can't walk into fire and still be, you know, without protection. So change your own environment and then you can change others. When I started getting close to God, the difference in my patience, Father saw me before on set in my own home. The willingness to forgive. I'm not saying I'm perfect, not at all, but I'm saying that's how God changed my heart. My relationship with my mother improved, with my father, even in Germany, parang malapit na maging 7 months na mag-isa siya in his home. He's even started he ordered his first study Bible just a couple of days ago, and he's received it. He's growing in faith. My sister as well. I've never been as close to my sister in my whole life. Mm. I've gained friends that are not just friends, that the first time that I met them, I knew that we were brothers and we hadn't said a word to each other. So in so many ways, but I always talk about it so vibrantly. I say this sentence all the time to all my friends who don't know God or don't want to believe in Him. I talk about Jesus because it's not like I'm trying to force Him down your throat. But if you know, if kung alam mo lang kung ano yung nangyari sa akin, kung paano niya binago yung buhay ko, then you would do the same as me. So about changing the world, you can really only change your environment, and you can't change the environment of others before you've changed your own. But if you think about it as you have a friend who you want to, who's an alcoholic or a drug addict, and you want to help save them or be used as an instrument to save them, you cannot have an influence over them if the influence of alcohol is stronger than the influence that God has on your life. You can't, you can't walk into fire and still be, you know, without protection. So change your own environment and then you can change others. Yan ang point perspective ko. What I believe that He's called me to do, it's given me a large sense of peace, because in my work, of course, we all know there's a lot of things going on, not just in the world, but within ABS-CBN.
Correct,
country, and there's a lot of uncertainty. Money, it's an uncertainty. You don't know where it's gonna come from. You don't know where opportunity is gonna come from, where the future is. There's no 5-year plan. I'm not thinking past the end of this year. I can't. I'll get worried or anxious. I can't. But it's given me the peace knowing that God has put me here. It was never my plan or my dream to be where I am. I didn't grow up wanting this, but I'm here. And I'm grateful and I'm blessed. But since He put me here, I will not be afraid, because I know He wants me here.
Yeah.
So it's given me, to answer the question, a large sense of peace. And because of my relationship with Him and because of the realizations of that, I prioritize my time with Him over everything else. But I actually went through a 3-day fast during quarantine a couple of months ago, actually. Mm-hmm. Maybe 2 months ago. Or a little less. And I was trying to get some certain answers to certain questions, and I was trying to restrict God to a yes, no, or not yet. Usually you look for the 3 answers to prayers. So I was trying to get a yes, no, or not yet, and He said none of them. It's like the what was that verse that we were talking with the coin, where He
give unto Caesar what is Caesar's, and
yes, it was that, it was sort of like that verse. He didn't give one of the 2 answers. He did not refuse to answer. He gave a completely different answer that answered the whole question in a different way. And He said, love me first before anything and anyone else.
And everything else will follow.
And everything else will follow. And He showed that. So when I started really prioritizing my time with Him in prayer, in reading the Word, in worship, and I noticed in the times I don't do that, everything in my day is just a little bit worse. If I play video games, Father, I'm not good at the video games anymore. If I have to do work,
but I like, but I like the way you put that, Edward. Everything is a little bit worse.
It's true, and it's like when you don't carry the presence or the Holy Spirit with you, things just, you know, the sky's a little darker, and a lot of people might see that as like, parang oh inaman, Edward. It's okay, but it's my experience in that sense that if I don't start my day and end my day with God at the center and at the helm of it, it's worse. So that's how it's changed my mission. It's given me comfort not to worry about the future. Yeah. And in the process, because God promises to be with us about in the center of the storm. Like if blowing around you, He will find you at the center. So in the middle of work, I know He's with me in the process.
Yeah, you know, Edward.